know, you want to start off doing your eggs right. And one of the things we did, we just took these eggs out of our fish. And if we were going to head home, one of the biggest mistakes guys do is they'll put their eggs in a plastic bag and sit them on ice with their fish. And by the time they get home, the ice have jellied out. They get dark brown and they get jellied because the water in the egg freezes from the ice. So what you have to do, and you don't want that. So if you have to put them in a bag, you want to cure them before you do it. But the best way to do it is either bring a Tupperware container for your eggs along with you, like I did, or if you have to put them in a plastic bag, go to the garbage and get a beer container, a beer six-pack carton, some kind of plastic or newspaper, and put the newspaper between the ice and then your bag of eggs on top of it so that the eggs are not directly on your ice. Because if you put your eggs directly on the ice, it will slowly freeze them and you'll ruin your eggs. So you want to start out with good eggs. And then once we have good eggs, what I like to do is put some cure on my eggs right away. It's just initial stage, it's not the drying process, but you want to get some cure on them right away. So what I'll normally do is I'll start to cut them up, or at least split them. Make sure you don't cut your hand, because it's real easy to do that when you're doing this step. I got them butterflied open like that. Down like that, start with my next one, hold it like this. And again, you don't want to go completely through the skein. You want to do it just like this. I like a scissor better than a knife, but if you're going to use a knife, use a sharp one. And gently butterfly your eggs open like that. And basically, I start to put my cure on. And you don't need a huge amount. This is Procure's, this is the original Procure formula with tuna powder added to it. And it's a killer cure. I really like it for fall fish, but it will work for any kind of salmon or steelhead. Tuna's just been deadly. It's a great thing to add. So what I'm gonna do is get this ready to go. Take my skein like this. I start to sprinkle my Procure on, and not overly heavily. Try to get some cure between the folds, like this. A little bit of a breeze blowing here, so it makes it a little bit more difficult. But again, I got a pretty good coverage. Flip them over, get the other side. Like that. Let them sit like that for a minute, start to juice up. I might want to add a little bit more Procure when I get home, but right now this is just to transport them, take good care of them. You see they're turning a real nice red color already. Just want to make sure any spots I missed. Now after they make their first initial juicing, and they'll start to make a bunch of juice right now, just kind of roll it around gently like this. Make sure it gets into them really well, into all the folds, and they'll start to make their own juice. And they're perfect to transport. You can put these on your eggs, on your ice, no problem at all. They'll just be really safe. If you had to freeze them right now, you could go ahead in about 20 minutes and freeze them. If you had to, you don't have to worry about them freezing anymore. You could put them in a plastic bag right now and they won't freeze because the salts from the egg cure go in and protect the eggs. So anyway, so that's what I do. And normally when I get home, I'll cut them into more usable skein-sized pieces, fish-sized pieces, and I'll squirt my bloody tuna oil on them. Basically, I'll let the cure work, but I'll take my tuna oil, squirt it on my eggs like that, and as the moisture comes out of my eggs, the tuna oil will get absorbed in along with all the curing ingredients, and it just makes a really killer egg. Just roll it around like that. And that oil will now get infused into the egg, into each individual egg, and it's really, really an effective way to scent your eggs. And then they're ready to be put up. I go home, I'll cut them into skein-sized pieces, lay them out on my tray, let them drain, and they'll be ready to go in 2 or 3 days.